login accepted.
What is going on, my YouTube friends? Today, in this Python lesson, we are going to create a source code analysis tool. And what this tool will do will allow you to scan source code to find potentially vulnerable source code. So, in our last lesson, we learned how to read and write files in Python. So we're going to expand on that by opening up lines of source code, stepping through them line by line, checking them to see if they're using any potentially vulnerable functions, and then if they are, print that to the screen for the user. These tools greatly increase the productivity in finding security vulnerabilities in software. So I already have a list here of PHP functions that can potentially contain security vulnerabilities, and I have them sectioned off by their type. So we're going to step through lines of source code and look for each one of these functions. And if it finds it, print it to the screen. So let's get to this. So first thing first, I just want to go ahead and give you a demonstration of what we're going to create. And you can see here, it is a PHP source code analyzer. And if the user does not provide any input, just like most command line programs, it will give the user the proper command line to execute this program. And in this case, we simply need to pass an input file, and which would obviously be a file containing source code. Inside this directory, I have a bunch of PHP files, and we are going to scan them. So this program is just very basic, so it's only set up right now to scan one file at a time, but we're going to expand upon this program and add a lot more features into it. So let's go ahead and pass in a file. And there you go, it has scanned that file and found several potential lines of code that could contain security vulnerabilities that we could exploit. So you can see it shows the file that was processed, the line number that the potential vulnerability was found, and then lastly, the type of vulnerability. So you can see we have several here. All right, so let's write our code. All right, we're going to start out by adding a path to our interpreter. And we're going to process command line arguments, so we need to add an import sys in order to help facilitate that. So like I said, this is a very simple and basic analyzer. So it's just going to consist of one main routine. We're just going to create one routine that will take a file name, and then it'll do all the processing, all the checking, all the printing to the screen, everything. So let's write that now. And I'm just going to call that ref file, short for review file. We'll give a parameter FLE, and this will be the file name that gets passed to this routine. Now we're going to need a counter to keep track of which line of code we're currently analyzing. So I'll create that now and give it a starting value of 1. Now we need to open our file. I'm going to create a variable named file, and then open the file that was passed to us. And I'm going to open that in read mode. And as we've learned in the last lesson, we're now going to loop through our file line by line. So we're going to, basically what that's saying is go through each line of the file. And as we step through each line, pass that data to the line variable. And this is going to be the meat of our program. Inside this for loop is where we're going to check for each different function type. So we basically need to create a series of if statements that will check for each type of PHP function that could potentially contain a security vulnerability. And then if it finds it, it needs to print the appropriate information to the screen for the user. So let's do that. So if, and the first one we had was the include function, as we see right here, and this is a local remote file inclusion. So we'll just call that an inclusion bug. Right. So if this text is found inside the line, then that means we found it and we need to print the appropriate information to the screen. So we'll start by printing the file name, and then we're going to print the current line number. Remember, we have to wrap that in the string function to convert that to a string. Close that off. And then we'll, this was an inclusion. And then we'll do our line of code. All right, so now we need to do that a bunch more times for all of the other functions. So luckily I've already done that. And I can just copy and paste it. But as you can see, we have all the other functions and their appropriate type. Right, so let's make sure that, let's fix that. All right, so now we have each if statement. And then before we finish with that, we need to increment our counter by one. So we can do that by doing C equals C plus one, or you can do the shorthand way, which is C plus equals one. All right, so that is basically the end of our routine. So that's basically the meat of the program. That's the program that's going to scan through each line of the file, check it against each one of these PHP functions, and if it finds it, it'll print it out to the screen. So now we need to create our main function that handles the execution of our program and, you know, handles the whether or not the user inputted any arguments. And if they didn't, give them the appropriate message. And if they did, execute the program. So create our main function. We need a variable for the file that we're going to be scanning. Now we need to check to see if the user passed any arguments. And we can do that by using the sys.argv variable. And that's just basically saying how many variables are inside the argv array. And you might think you'd want to check for less than one, but actually the first variable is actually the file name that was executed. So we need to check for less than two. So if less than two variables were passed, then we know the user did not supply a source file, so we should print to the screen a message. So I'll start our message with backslash in, and that's basically saying start on a new line. Actually, instead of hard coding the file name, what we should do is use the system arguments, because remember the first variable is the file name that was typed. Because if somebody renames this file to something other than analyzer.py, or, you know, if we hard coded it, it wouldn't be accurate. They wouldn't be the same. But instead, if we use the sys.argv and use the first value of the array, that will be the file name that was typed. So we'll use that. And let's say input source file. Actually, let's stay consistent here. And then finally, we need to quit the program. So if a user runs our program and does not provide a argument, then it will print this message and the program will quit. Let's go ahead and add a final new line. All right, so there is that. Now, if the user does provide an argument, then we want to execute our program. So we will first actually just declare the file that the user provided. Oops, I did this wrong. Because remember, arrays are at zero. So, source file one. And then finally, call our routine with the file that was provided by the user. All right. So let me just look at this real quick, make sure everything looks okay. That looks right. All right, so let's go ahead and save this. If let's change mode, then let's run it. Perfect. So you can see when it says analyzer.py, let's go ahead and move the file to let's just call it check.py. Let's run it again. And you can see, didn't change the source code. And it says check.py. So let's move it back. All right, so now let's see if it actually works. So we'll pass one of our PHP files to it. And awesome, look at that. We have our output. And we have several lines of code to take a look at to see if we could potentially exploit. Something else you can do is you can pipe this output to a file. So we could do something like this, and then the output from our file will now be in this file. So now we can reference that for later. There you have it, guys. So as you can see, with just a little bit of Python knowledge, you can really create some programs that are very useful. So that's gonna do it for this episode, guys. I greatly appreciate you watching. I'm gonna start doing more live videos. I did that last night and that was a lot of fun. I think everybody enjoyed it. It was really cool interacting with everybody. And you guys got to see firsthand, you know, how exactly you go about auditing some code. So anyways, that's going to be coming up. If you like this video, please throw me a thumbs up. I greatly appreciate it. If you have not subscribed, do so now. Click that subscribe button. That way you'll get notifications of my new videos. And I will see you guys on the other side.
acceptance.